Welcome back to Prisonberry Fieldhouse on the campus of Augustine University. We are at halftime of our game between the Jaguars and the Emmanuel Lions. Jags lead 47-31. Probably worth mentioning, it's Education Day here at Prisonberry Fieldhouse. We've got a couple of thousand fifth and sixth graders having a good time. Remember when you were in school. Remember when you didn't have to go to school. That's what they're doing today. No, they'll go back to school, but they get out for a little while to watch some basketball. And they're watching the Jags leading at the half. Jags are 14 of 30 from the field for 47%. 7 of 15 shooting threes for 47%. They've made all 12 of their free throws. As far as the Lions are concerned, they are 11 of 24 from the field. One and only game Jaguars play at Prisonberry Fieldhouse in December. They will be back after the first of the year.
And what an outstanding first half. And one thing that jumps out to me, as you mentioned during the bringing down the stats, John, is for Emmanuel, they haven't really shared the ball as much as the Jaguars have. They have just one guy with 20 points.
And yeah.
That's almost about it. The rest of the team with just 11. And Miguel Arnold leads the way with the Jaguars with 15. And the second leading scorer is Darren Lucas White. He has 8 points. So the Jaguars sharing the ball a lot more, and it's showed right since the start. And obviously the Jaguars have fed off this awesome crowd.
Lions get the ball to start the second half as we are underway here at Prisonberry. Simpson, a little short on the short shot. And we've got our first whistle and foul of the second half. That was on Kyler Ingram. Kyler's first. First foul of the second half for the Lions. Jags with the basketball now. Darren gets it to Tyvez, Miguel, Rafael, and Dean in the ball game for the Jags to start the second half. Rafael works his man in and travels. Probably just before 3 seconds he's going to get called.
The important thing for the Jaguars here at the start of the second half is you got to pick up right where you left off and don't let Emmanuel come into the second half thinking they can get back in this game. You got to really start the closeout process now.
The last 5 minutes of a first half, first 5 minutes of a second half, always important.
For momentum's sake.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Turnover for the Lions. Darren crosses midcourt. They go right, Lions with the basketball now, driving down the lane, putting up the shot, scoring the basket, Holden. And he will go to the line. Holden with 22 points this afternoon. Fails to convert. Jags up the court now. Dean dishes back out to Miguel. Tries to get it back to Dean. They're going to call that a travel on Miguel. Turnover for the Jags. Jags in this ball game at 4-2. Lions are 5-3. Colvin dishes off. Right-handed turnaround is no good for Ingram. Miguel, one on two, waving off that basket.
I believe a foul is going to be called before the shot on Emmanuel.
Jags will inbound. We'll have 26 seconds on the shot clock. A three is no good for Rafael. Pass it off to Simpson, who drives in the lane, cannot convert. Ball's tapped up. Nice play there by Brandon Simpson. Bangs it off a jag. It'll be Lions basketball. Lions inbound. That's batted away by Dean. Darren up the court quickly, lays up the left-hander, good. 10 points for Darren this afternoon. Jags now up 51-33, 17 and a half to go in the ball game. And we're gonna have a foul on the Lions. That was on Brandon Simpson, his second. Team's third turnover for the Lions. And then we're going to have an offensive foul on Darren. That's going to be his first. Going to be the Jags' second of the half. Green to Simpson. Trying to get it to Colvin, cannot. Simpson drives down the lane. Banks the shot in. He's got seven. Jags still up 16. Fight for the basketball. I think we've said Jags' foot was on the line. So that ball will go to the Lions. 16:48 to go, first half, second half. Dipmetris making wholesale changes. Tyree is in, Troy is in. Tyree is back in, as is Robert Barland. First time we've seen Robert in a couple of games. Long three, misses everything. Robert pulls down that rebound. Tyree up the court to Troy. Sean Moss also in the game for the Jags. What a left-handed shot by Roberts, no good. Dish off under the basket. Shot is missed, but the Lions retain possession. It's going to be a foul on Robert. First foul on Robert. We're going to have our media timeout. 15:55 to go in the ball game. Jags up 16, 51-35. .55 to go in the ball game. Jags with a 16-point lead. Mikel Tyson at the line misses the first.
and does not get the second one to fall either. Fight for the basketball, and nice play there by Kendrick Colvin. He's got 24 on the afternoon. Barry gets it over to Sean. Sean back to Troy. Left side three for Sean. Good. First three of the afternoon for Sean. Foster gets it to Colvin. Colvin working Troy. Picks up his dribble. Long three, lefties, no good. We've got a whistle and a foul.
At the time of the three, there were 7 seconds on the shot clock, and that's important for the Jaguars, playing good defense and forcing Emmanuel to take time off the clock with a 17-point lead. That's huge.
Second foul for Robert Barland. Get it inside to Colvin. Guarded by Troy. Kendrick backs him up. Dishes out. We've got another whistle and yet another foul, this time two on the Jaguars. It's going to be on Tyree Myers. Tyree's first, team's fifth. Foster with the basketball now. Exchanges with Williams. Sampson for three. Back of the rim, no good. Sean pulls down that rebound for the Jags. Troy with the basketball. This is back to Sean. And a whistle. Foul on the Jaguars. That's the third foul on Robert. 14-18 to go in the ball game. Jags still up 17. Jack Fitzpatrick checking in for the Lions. That's Jack there. Gets it to Tyson. Simpson scores the two. 9 points for Brandon. And the starting five will return to the ball game for the Jaguars.
Jaguars able to get them a little bit of rest and then keep them fresh to go back out there for a certain stretch.
Got a foul on the Lions. First foul on Tyson, team's fourth foul. The starting five for the Jags return. Darren, Rafael, Tyvez, Dean, and Miguel. Darren on the right side, gets it back top of the key. Miguel for three, good. Simpson dishes back out to Colvin. Colvin drives down the lane. Dishes off back to Simpson. Nice play there.
It was wide open, and he found the perfect hole to bounce the ball right through to get him in position for the reverse lane.
It's 11 points for Brandon. Miguel, right side, no good. Ball's batted around. Gonna have a foul on Tyson.
What we're seeing here this half that's different from the first half is they've shared the ball a little more, and the lack of sharing the ball hurt them in the first half, and now, as a result, this half, they're not letting the Jaguars end the lead more than they already have.
Yeah, they've stayed with the Jags here in the Christenberry Fieldhouse. Got a whistle.
No, they're very creative.
Fitzpatrick dishes off. Cross-court pass to Simpson. Foster. Foster loses the handle. Turnover, Lions. Coleman drives in the lane, picks up his dribble, and travels. We're going to have timeout. 11:52 to go in the ball game. Jags up 57-41. Tries to draw. Got a foul. Jags. Eighth team foul, so the Lions are in the bonus. Kendrick with 24 already on the afternoon. Makes the first. And he misses the second. Foul on the Lions. Foul is on Charlie Velasquez. Oh, slam home for Dean Williams.
What a beautiful alley-oop on the inbound. Doesn't that remind you of the end of regulation in Saturday's game?
Yeah, yeah. Got the kids excited. They tuned back in. Going to be a travel called on Foster. Isaiah turns it over. Darren with the basketball now. And it's going to be an offensive foul on Darren. Second foul on Darren. Lions will inbound. Still trail by 17. We've got a Lions foul. That's what we're doing. We're just going back and forth up the court with fouls.
It's a physical game, not even halfway through this half, and
yeah.
The Jaguars already with 19 fouls, which puts the Lions in double bonus, and the Lions with 7 already.
Jackson Bailey committing that foul.
But that's something that you want to be careful about with your Jaguars so you don't let the Lions get back in this game at the free throw line.
Darren turns the ball over. And we're going to have a foul.
And that's the 10th on the Jaguars. So, like I said, Lions will be able to shoot free throws.
Darren's third. And we'll walk to the other end of the court as now the Lions are in the double bonus.
And with the physicality we're seeing in the second half, foul trouble may become a factor later in this game. Something to keep an eye on.
First free throw is good for Bailey. Tyree Myers back in the game for the Jags. And he makes the second. And we've got a timeout. 10:28 to go in the ball game. Jags up 59-44. Apparently have had a technical call. Miguel at the line to shoot the free throw. And he makes it.
Jaguars in the first half of the first half, that's before the 10-minute mark of the first half, almost 30 points they had scored. Like, their offense got off to a really fast start.
And now just 60. And it still looks like Coach Rosine wants to know what the technical is about. That is getting explained to him. Dip leaning in. He'd like to know himself.
Nevertheless, the Jaguars get the free throw, and now they have the ball.
Conversation continues. And I would say the conversation concludes to everyone's satisfaction, but I have a feeling that wouldn't be true. Tyree with the basketball now. Gets it over to Miguel, back to Dean. Shot taken into the front of the rim from Miguel. Foster up the court quickly. Lays up the left-handed. Doesn't fall. Follow-up is good. And we're going to score that basket for Jackson Bailey. And Jackson will go to the line to try to convert the three-point play and get the Lions back to within 13.
As a result of all the whistles, there's not been a lot of time allowed to go by here in the second half.
Troy checks back in for the Jags. Bailey's free throw is good. He's got 5 points, and the Lions are indeed within 13.
Jaguars have led in this game since the beginning. They have not trailed.
Try to get it inside to Dean. Ball's battled away and saved by the Jags. 10 on the shot clock. Dish off to Troy, who lays it up and in. Holden, who has not been able to score with the same efficiency he did in the first half. We've got a turnover there on the Lions, a travel.
And if you're the Lions, that's just a bad fundamental mistake that you really can't have. And of course, Jaguars have a chance to take advantage.
Tyree with the basketball now. Troy sets the screen. 13 on the shot clock as Tyree drives in there and cannot convert. Bailey comes out with the basketball and gets it to Green. Long three, finds the bottom for Derek Vandenberg. And all of a sudden, they're within 12. Taking a bite out of the Jaguar lead, one bite at a time. Inside to Dean. Dean follows up. Good. Turnover for the Lions. Just about 8 minutes to go in the ball game. Jags still up 14. Kyrie drives, stops, pops, misses. Colvin gonna take it all the way. Score the basket, Kendrick Colvin. He's got 28. I apologize. Ball will stay with the Jags. We're gonna have our media timeout, 7:28 to go. Jags up 64-52. Back at Christenberry Fieldhouse, 7:28 to go in the ball game. Jags have not trailed in the game. They've led by as many as 17. They find themselves up 12. They've got the basketball. Trying to inbound. They do get it to Dean, gets it back to Tyree. Tyree thought he was fouled, and he was. I don't think Mr. Green thought he fouled Tyree. Third foul on Austin. 18 fouls, and now the Jags are in the bonus. Tyree will go to the line. He's got 8 points. Gets the first one to fall. Misses the second. Williams with the basketball, gets it over to Colvin. Get it over to Green. He's going for the alley-oop. Colvin misses and is fouled.
The foul will be adjusted to the
fourth foul on Tyvez. Colvin will go to the line where he's got 27 points. And he makes the first. Rafael Montero back in the game for the Jags. And he makes the free throws. Aaron in the game gives it to Dean, who fires the three too hard. Long three is no good. Follow-up is good for Kyler Ingram. And now it's a 9-point Jaguar lead. Ball's battled away. Here comes Colvin. He'll take it all the way. No foul. Aaron swings it to Dean. Back to Tyree. Seven on the shot clock. Rafael backs his man up, throws up the right-hander. Little baby hook is good. Long three, yes, for Vandeveer.
First time this half, lines have been within single digits. They're not going away.
Tyree at the free throw line, gets it over to Dean. He drives in the lane, dishes off. And nice basket there for Rafael. Rafael's got 10 now. Thought about the long three, gets a little closer. There's the long three. That's no good. Dean pulls that rebound down. Left side, no, misses everything. Shot clock at 18, this time Aaron for three, no good. Nice play inside to Green, and Green draws the foul. That, is the first foul on Dean. Austin Green will go to the line. He's got a couple of points on the afternoon. Tyvez back in, Miguel back in.
Jaguars, you got to take care of the basketball.
Simpson checks back in.
And it definitely doesn't hurt to add padding to your lead at this point as well.
Jags up 9. 4.5 to go in the ball game. Nice dish off. Rafael cannot convert. He does draw the foul.
He's going to shoot two, and that's the 9th team foul on the Lions, so it's double bonus the rest of the way for both sides with 4:12 to play. And free throws at this point are huge. here at the Jaguars.
Raphael with 10 on the afternoon. Misses the first. Oh, okay. Now the third missed free throw.
A three-score game. Here's we have
and we're going to have a foul on Dean, I believe. Olvin will go back to the line. Second foul on Dean. Here's our final media timeout, 3:50. Back at Christenberry Fieldhouse, 3:52 to go. Holman will be at the line. And there's his 30th point of the afternoon. His 31st. He's got half their points on the afternoon. Tyreek comes right, gets it inside to Dean. Dean tries drawing the foul. Jump ball, and that will go to the Jags.
On the shot clock.
Yep. Shot is no good. Dean. Dean draws the foul.
No, an offensive foul. They're going to say he pushed off in pursuit of the rebound.
Actually, they called that on Raphael. That is Raphael's.
So a push off
foul.
Away from the ball.
Yeah.
And that's going to cost the Jaguars, and the Lions have a chance to cut to four. As they've been gradually chipping away and getting closer and closer as this half has gone on, a half in which they began trailing by 16 points, and they were down 16 as well with about 10 to go before the chipping away began.
A diver at the line makes the first.
And interesting, Emmanuel has three people back on defense already.
The diver makes them both. And they're within five.
That would have given the Jaguars easy access to a rebound off of this shot.
Which leads me to believe they know he's a pretty good free throw shooter.
And it showed there, he made both.
Yep. Dean tries the dish off. Turnover Jaguars. Again, with a five-point lead and 3:04 to go.
Montero, it was a little bit out of his reach, but good defense by the Lions to stop him from getting there as he had a tough route to get to that one, and as a result, it went out of bounds.
Nathan Williams back in for the Lions. Simpson with the basketball now. Theoretically, could get to within two. Old Sylvan drives baseline on Dean, puts up the left-hander, no good. Fight for the rebound, Jags come away with it importantly.
Jaguars need a basket here. There's no sugarcoating the situation.
Nice dish to Miguel, gets it to fall.
And that's beautiful. It was good defense there, but he was able to thread it right through the defenders to Miguel, who was wide open for the layup. And Miguel was in the perfect position to take it the rest of the way.
Colvin picks up his dribble, tries dishing it off. Fouls on Dean. Third foul on Dean. Again, we'll send Colvin to the line with his 31 points.
Jaguars scored 47 points in half number one. So far in the first almost 18 minutes of this half, only 24 points.
And he misses the first free throw.
So the Lions defense has really made the adjustments and stepped up.
Second one is short. Jags dodged that bullet. Chavez with 10 on the shot clock. And they swing it left. 5 on the shot clock. Long 3, no good. Simpson pulls down that rebound. Gets it to Colvin. Kendrick drives into the lane, puts his shoulder down, throws up the little left-hander for 33 points.
And that's a very acrobatic move because Dean Williams was in perfect position with his feet planted ready to take the charge, and he was able to go around him and still get it to go.
Jags by 7. Getting down to the last minute of the ball game. Jags will burn some clock.
And it's still too early for the Lions to foul.
Jags actually up 5, sorry. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Gotta put it up. Little fadeaway, hits the front of the rim, no good. Fight for the rebound. And the Lions come away with it. They've got time. Simpson gets it into. Batted away by Dean.
And now it's definitely foul time for the Lions.
Yep, whistle and the foul.
And now Dip can put his best free throw shooters in.
Tyvez will go to the line. Jags up 5. 32 seconds to go in the ballgame. First free throw is short.
Now if he can make the second free throw, it'll be a 6-point game, which means that the Lions will need 2 threes to tie the game. And obviously it's still early enough that they can go for a quick 2.
Misses them both. Coleman with the rebound up the court quickly. He'll take it all the way. Draws the foul. Fouls on Rafael. And that'll do it for Rafael. He has fouled out.
A good game for him, though. 10 points in this one. And he was a major contributor today, for sure. And he's going to have to sit the rest of this one out.
Kendrick Colvin at the line. 32 points. Makes the first. Gets them both to fall, and the Lions want a timeout. 26 seconds to go. The Jags are up 3. Jag ball. Odds are the Lions will foul. They are down three. Tyvez will inbound. Long throw, arcing pass. Dean comes away with it, and there's the foul.
And that's a dangerous high pass because it gives the Lions plenty of time to get under it. Thankfully, Dean Williams was in perfect position to go up and try to score. And if you're the Jaguars, if you get an easy shot in the basket, even though the shot clock said you want to score, take the shot because you know the Lions are going to foul and put you at the line anyway, so you might as well take the easy shot.
Fourth foul on Simpson.
That's ruled a flagrant, so the Jaguars, how huge is this? Two shots and the ball. As the Lions were a little too aggressive on that.
Makes the first.
These students here don't know that when the home team is shooting free throws, you're supposed to quiet down. But it didn't matter there. He made the first anyway. They'll live and learn, though.
That is quiet for fifth and sixth graders, by the way. That's as quiet as they get.
I don't know if either of us were that loud at that age.
Oh yeah. Let me say, yeah, I'm sure you were. I'm sure we were. All right, 20.8 seconds to go. 72-68. Jags up four. I'm thinking when this education game was scheduled and Emmanuel was scheduled to come in, I don't know that Dip thought it'd be a four-point lead with 20.8 seconds to go.
And because of the flagrant foul, the Jaguars very likely will have more free throws coming off of this timeout. And they're trying to draw it up and put it in the right guys in this game. And draw up getting it open and at least trying to put players in a good position to take as much time off the clock as they can before Emmanuel fouls.
Tyvez will inbound or attempt to do so. Here's the foul. They'll send Tyree to the line. Two important free throws for Tyree.
If he makes them both, a six-point game, like I said before, will mean the Lions will need two threes to tie the game.
Makes the first. Gets them both. Green up the court quickly, taking it all the way, trying to draw the foul. He does draw the foul, does not score the basket.
Now, if you're the Lions, obviously you'll try to make the first free throw, but is it too early to miss the second free throw on purpose and get a little closer by an offensive rebound?
Yeah, no, it's not too
early. Cut it to a one-score game?
It's not too early. 13 seconds.
The Lions only with one player back. Last time in this situation, they had basically everybody back. So now they're preparing for an offensive rebound, if necessary, to try and get closer.
Got to hit the rim. Not allowed to miss everything.
Backboard does not count in that situation.
Made them both. This will be the inbound, this will be the foul. There's the inbound, there's the foul.
Here the Jaguars, when you're facing a full court press, you want to get it into whoever's open, regardless of their free throw shooting ability at this point. And then if you have a chance, then get it to your best foul shooter.
Miguel will go to the line. Matt Simpson's fifth foul.
So now we've seen one player on each team foul on this one. I did mention earlier that foul trouble will become a factor in this game. When both teams were in the double bonus with 10 to go, it's inevitable.
Miguel at the line. Still a couple of important free throws. Misses the first.
Now, regardless of what happens here, the Lions can make it a one-score game with just a two. But they'll definitely be in hurry-up mode here.
Does make the second. And now Dip wants a timeout.
He wants to rotate his guys. He had the best free throw shooters in for offense, and now he wants to put the best defense in. And he wants to make sure the Lions don't get an easy shot and force the Lions to take a little extra time before they can get that kind of look as well. If you're the Lions, would you go for a three here down five?
Well, if you have the opening.
Not like I said, a two would make it a three-point game. Jaguars with full-court press.
Lions inbounding. Here comes Colvin. Here's the three. Short. And they'll foul.
And
that may do it.
John, you said short before it even came close to the rim. You could tell right away.
Yeah, I've seen a few of these.
And that'll just about do it. But a good icing on the cake here would be to make both and make it a three-score game. For sure. I've seen stranger things happen, though.
Oh, sure. Kyrie at the line can make this a seven-point lead with 5 seconds to go and make a couple of thousand kids happy. Makes the first.
Invite you all to stay tuned for some of the post-game coverage here, and we might get a player interview up here for a little post-game interview if possible, and we'll break down the way this game went. Invite you to stay tuned for some post-game when this is over.
And he makes them both. Quickly up the court. Green fires the three. No good. That's your ball game. Final score, Jag 77 and the Lions 70. Jags will go to 5-2 on the year. The Lions will fall to 5-4. Some stats from the game. Lions were 22 of 51, shot 43%. Jags were 24 of 55, they shot 44%. Lions 5 of 13, shooting threes for 38%. Jags 9 of 24 for 38%. Lions were 21 of 31 from the line for 68%. Jags just a little bit better, 19 of 26 for 73%. Kendrick Colvin led everybody with 35 points. Brandon Simpson with 11. Derek Vandever with 8. Austin Green with 5. Jackson Bailey 5. Nathan Williams 4. Kyler Ingram with 2. For the Jags, Miguel Arnold had 22, Tyree Myers had 12, Dean Williams with 11, Darren Lucas White with 10, Rafael Mantero with 10, Aaron Bird with 4, Troy Krasner with 4, Sean Moss with 3. So the Jags wrap up their first, the 2018 part of the 2018-2019 season. They are 5-2, and they will be back here at Christenberry after the first of the year. Robert and Blake will have the post-game show for you. I'm John Patrick. Have a great Christmas and a happy new year. Robert and Blake will be coming back.